An n times m matrix A is called invertible. Called invertible if another matrix exists, an n times m matrix B, such that if we form the products AB and BA, they are equal and they result in the identity matrix, the n by n identity matrix. And we write B is A minus 1, or the inverse of A. Well, the notion of the inverse of a matrix, if it exists, is well defined. What do we mean by that? There's at most one inverse, so we actually may define it. If there were two, we would have problems. Well, to show this, we can see this as follows. Suppose we have two inverses for A. B and C are both inverses of A. And what we know is that A times B is B times A equals the identity matrix. And also A times C equals C times A is also the identity matrix. Then B is B times the identity matrix, of course, equals B times A times C, because A times C is also the identity matrix. And since we have associativity of the matrix multiplication, this equals B times A times C. And B times A equals the identity matrix. And identity matrix times C equals C. So then we have that B should be equal to C. So actually there is at most one inverse of a matrix A. So this means that the definition is good. Well, an example. Consider the following matrix. Yeah, so let A be the following 2 by 2 matrix, so 3, 5, 1, 2. Then this matrix A is invertible. Later on we're going to calculate actually the inverses of a matrix. But now I just propose a matrix. A inverse is 2 minus 5 minus 1, 3. So in order to show that this is actually the inverse of A, we form the products of these two matrices. A times the inverse, which should result in the identity matrix. So we multiply 3, 5, 1, 2 with 2 minus 5 minus 1. 3 of minus 1 minus, and 3. So the first row with the first column yields 3 times 2 is 6 minus 5, and the second term we get 1 minus 2 and minus 15 plus 15, and the second row and the second column yields minus 5 plus 6. So if we carry out these calculations, we get 1 here, 0 there, and 1 there. So this equals the identity matrix, the 2 by 2 identity matrix. Well, the other way around, A inverse, well, what is supposed to be the inverse of A times A. Now perform the similar calculations. So first column, first row is 6 minus 5, etc., etc. 10 minus 10 minus 3 plus 3 minus 5 plus 6 yields 1, 0, 0, 1. Again, the identity matrix, the 2 by 2 identity matrix. So indeed, an inverse, or the matrix that we propose here, is the inverse of 3, 5, 1, 2.